Next one is the nutrition of ostrich. Strothiocamelus are grazing birds on the open woodland habitat, hence can be reared in paddock along with sheep, goat and cattle, said by Abbas et al. In 2017. These are omnivores and can eat shoots, shrubs, leaves, seeds, fruits, as well as insects and lizards. The ostriches are reared worldwide for their feathers, skin, eggs, and meat. The diet of the ostrich mainly consists of seeds and other plant matter. Though occasionally, it is also eat insects such as locusts. They are known to eat almost anything and can carry out 1 kg of stones in its stomach. It was said by Abbas et al. In 2017. Kickstarter rations, very high in protein, are not recommended because high protein diets may be associated with leg abnormalities in turkeys. Here are the nutritional requirements of the ostriches at first, second, third, and fourth stage of age. Here are mentioned energy, protein, lysine, methionine, total sulfur, NDF percentage, crude fat, calcium, NPP percentage, and sodium. Next one is the breeder ration before the onset of production. Energy required is 2300 kilocalories, protein is 21%, lysine 1%, methionine 0.38%, total sulfur percentage is 0.7, NDF percentage 22 to 24%, CF percentage is 12 to 14%, calcium is 3 to 5%, 3.5%, NPP percentage 0.7, and sodium 0.2%. Here is the starter breeder feed pellets. Next are the problems or diseases during rearing phase. Omphalitis or infected yolk sac is a common disease of hatchlings. It has been treated by surgical removal of the yolk sac followed by antibiotic therapy. Infected yolk sacs are a result of bacteria penetrating the eggshell. It should become a less common problem as egg gathering and sanitation practices improved. The fedding chick syndrome or male absorption syndrome is a usually fatal disease of young ostriches that strikes most often between 1 and 3rd month of age, but may affect chicks as old as 6 months. Chicks become restless, stop eating and drinking, and die. The cause is unknown. Aggressive intravenous fluid or oral fluid therapy has been successful in some cases. Infections occur in birds of all age. Treatment can be surgical or non-surgical. Preventive measure includes acclimation of chicks to a variety of substrates very early in the life and avoiding sudden feed changes or sudden addition of high roughages feedstuffs. Most birds can be treated by hobbling the legs together in a normal position with tape, tubing, stunt or vent trap until the chick is able to stand on its own. Next are the parasitic infestation. Both internal and external parasites affect the ostriches. Emeria species, protozoa, and Labistogalus douglasii nematodes cause serious production losses in the ostriches. Abbas et al. In 2017 said used ivermectin and piperazine citrate in poultry and recommended that piperazine citrate is more effective for the treatment of parasitic infestations. These anthelmintic and other drugs given a 1 month interval beginning at the 1 month of age will prevent nematode infestations. Ivermectin also may be effective against quill mites and suckling lice with repeated dosing. Histomoniasis infection can be controlled by furazolidone and treated with metronidazole. Carbaryl 5% dust is being used by the USDA at 14-day interval to treat tick infestations in chicks and adult ostriches. Levamisole for wireworms. Arthropod infestation in ostrich causing feather loss. Unidentified feather mites belonging to family Petrolichidae infestation ostrich successfully treated with ivermectin. Next are the viral diseases. Newcastle disease virus is highly virulent, causing high mortality in ostriches. Virus isolated from brain reported highly pathogenic. Vaccination of ostriches against ND is quite different to those associated with vaccination other poultry. Little is known of the immune response of vaccination in ostriches, yet some researchers have reported the successful use of vaccines under controlled experiments. All right, reported the efficiency of vaccine at 4 and 14 months of age, but also observed some reactions with adjuvant vaccines, especially oil-based vaccines. Overall, at all reported no clinical signs or death in ostriches of up to 10 months of age that had been vaccinated with live Lesota vaccine at 6 and 10 weeks of age, whereas unvaccinated ostriches show 100% morbidity and 25% mortality in the same conditions. Bottle et al. Recommended a schedule of live Lesota given by eye drop and two doses of oil emulsions inactivated vaccine of Talovac 105 ND Lowman Animal Health for high antibody levels in susceptible ostriches at the age of 8 and up to 12 months old. Pox virus recovered from skin lesions and spongy form encephalopathy is also reported. Crimean Congo hemorrhages fever virus is also reported worldwide. Report of virus isolation from human, though thought to have acquired infection from handling slaughter ostriches. However, even influenza and Newcastle disease are two main ostrich diseases in globe, whereas up till now there is not a single report of these diseases in Pakistan. To avoid the viral diseases, proper recommendation of vaccination schedule and described earlier should be followed. Staphylococcus aureus in an ostrich causing conjunctivitis colobacillus was reported for mortality more than 20% in young ostriches in flock imported from Belgium. In RC Vets Lahore, tuberculosis in ostrich and other retides is also reported. Pasteurella mattosida infections may cause generalized and pulmonary infections in ostriches. Treatment for the bacterial diseases is gentamicin 2 mg per pound, amoxicillin 5 mg per pound, tetracycline 7.5 mg per pound, tribersin 2 ml per kg, and sulfadiazine 48%, 20 milligram per pound. Next are the fungal diseases. Aspergillus infections caused by Aspergillus flavus and Aspergillus niger are also reported in ostriches. However, there are no evidences of aspergillosis as a flock. Birds show signs of depression, anorexia, and stunting. Some of the birds walked with their heads close to the ground and moved lethargically compared to the healthy chicks. Treatment of the fungal diseases is fumigate the hatchery with formalin and potassium permanganate. Change of litter, hay or sand frequently. Next are the nutritional deficiency disorders. Vitamin E and selenium deficiency, partially induced photosensitivity in captive ostrich, anasarca and myopathy in ostrich chicks, nutritional muscle dystrophy in ostrich chicks. Treatment and provide minerals and vitamin supplements. First of all, water. Assess to water 24 hours a day. Water temperature of 20 degrees centigrade for all groups of birds and not simply free from ice. Ostriches like to scope, and as a result of the feed in their beaks, the water trough gets dirty quickly and therefore need cleaning regularly. With regards supplying the chicks with water at night time, there are two schools of thoughts on this. One believes in that water should be restricted so that urine less and are therefore kept drier and the risk of falling into the water is also eliminated. Whilst the other school of thought believes that chicks should have access to water all the times. Water consumption is directly related to the feed consumption, and by restricting water, you would therefore be restricting feed intake.